Hello students, welcome to CS Academy platform. In this session, we will discuss problems regarding edges. These are the problems which are asked in SSC CGL. Okay, we will discuss these problems with short tricks and we can solve these problems within 10 or 20 seconds. Okay, let's start the session. The first question is, 4 years ago, the father's age was 3 times the age of son. And the total age of father and son after 4 years will be 64 years. And the question is, then what was the father's age at present? Okay, he is asking the present age of father. As I told in part 1, the short trick, please go through the part 1 before watching this video. And the short trick is here is, draw a horizontal line and divide that line into 3 parts. This is the present, this is past, and this is future. The question given, 4 years ago the father age was 3 times the age of son. That means he given the information regarding the past. So note it here. Father's age was 3 times the age of son. Let us consider, I am assuming son's age is X. Then what will the father's age? That is 3X. Yes or no? From the given data, I wrote this one. This is from the present to past, that is 4 years ago. That's why I am considering minus 4. Okay. And now the second point here is, the total age of father and son after 4 years will be 64 years. That means the present age of father and son is not given in the question. Okay. Directly we have to go to after 4 years. That means from the present to after 4 years. That is plus 4. And given that the total age of son and father is 64 years. Yes or no? 64 years. But here, the past, the son age is X and the father age is 3X. From here to here, the total age is the plus 4 and plus 4. Yes or no? This is the 4 years and this is the 4 years. From here to here, son age will be X plus 8 and father age will be 3X plus 8. The total age is equal to 64 years. Yes or no? If I add these two, 4X plus 16 equal to 64. Yes or no? That 4x is equal to 48. Yes or no? That x is equal to 12. Okay, we got the x value here. What he is asking in the question, that is, what was father's present age? He is asking the present age. Here we should note the father's age. Yes or no? If we substitute x value here, we will get the father's age 4 years ago. Yes or no? In the question, he is asking present age. So that we should add 3x plus 4. Yes or no? 3x plus 4 is the age of father's present. That is, father's present age is equal to 3x plus 4. That is equal to 3 into 12 plus 4. That is 40 years. Yes or no? So from out of 4 options, we should select the option B. Okay, this is a very shortcut method. If you practice more number of questions, you can easily solve like this. Okay, and if you see the second question here, the difference between present ages of A and B is 4 years. The ratio of their ages after 5 years will be 9:8. That is, the ratio of their ages after 5 years will be 9:8. The question he is asking, what is A's present age? A's present age. Here, this type of questions will be solved in a very less time and with the very best shortcut here. And forget about the total matter whatever given in the question. And let's focus on the question whatever he given. That is A's present age. Okay. A's present age. Yes or no? We want to find this A's present age. These are the options which is regarding the A's present age. Yes or no? That is, A's present age may be 32 years or 31 years or 36 years or 28 years. Out of these 4 options, one may be correct. Yes or no? Out of these 4 options, one may be the age of A's present age of A. Yes or no? Here, one more data given in the question, that is the ratio of their ages after 5 years. That is, after in the every question, just note like this, present, past, future. Okay, just note it like that. We won't confuse okay, during the solving the question. Okay, in the question given, the ratio of their ages after 5 years, that means after 5 years, that is the future, after 5 years. Yes or no? Here the ratio is given, that is a is to b equal to 9 is to 8. Yes or no? Now let us consider the ratio of a is to b after 5 years will be 45 is to 40. Let us consider, I am assuming this is. Yes or no? Is this two ratios are equal or not? That is 9 into 5 equal 45, 8 into 5 equal to 40. Yes or no? These two ratios are proportional to each other. That is, 9 is a multiple of age of A and 8 is a multiple of age of B. Yes or no? Like that here also, these are the ages of present age of A. If I add for the each option like 5, what will happen? This value will be multiple of 9. Yes or no? This value will be multiple of 9. That is 37 or 36 or 41 or 33. Out of these 4 options, these are the ages after 5 years. These are the ages of A after 5 years. These ages may be multiple of 9. Out of these 4 options, one may be the multiple of 9. Yes or no? If we compare these options with 9, so out of these 4 options, 36 may be the multiple of 9. Yes or no? 36 may be the multiple of 9. I hope you got the point here. These are the ages of present ages of A, and he given in the question the ages, the ratio of ages, their ratios will be 9 is to 8 after 5 years. Yes or no? And this 9 is to 8 is a multiple of their age ratio. 9 is to 8 is a multiple of their age ratio. That age ratio may be whatever it may be, that 45 is to 40 or whatever it may be. That should be multiple of 9 is to 8. For that, what I am doing here, I am just adding 5 years to these options. That is the present ages of A. So if I add each age 5 years to these options, what will happen? I will get the age of A after 5 years. So I can equate these two and I will get the answer. So here 36 years is the answer. But if you select this one, it is wrong. Because I am adding here 5 to this option, I am getting 36. Okay, that means it is the age of A after 5 years. It is the age of A after 5 years. But the correct age is 31. So we should select the option B. Okay, sometimes they will give options like this. With the excitement, we will directly select this one. So like this we have to answer. This is very best question and very tricky question. This is asked in a CGL, SSA CGL. Okay, and if you see the next question, that is the ratio between A and B is 2:3. That is the present age. I told before that during the solving of this ages concept, just write present, past and future. Okay, and in the question he given, the ratio between A and B is 2:3. That is A is to B is equal to 2:3. Okay, and here A is 6 years younger than B. A is 6 years younger than B. That is B minus A equal to 6. That is A is younger and B is elder. So if we subtract these two ages, we will get 6. In the question he given like this. And in the question he is asking the ratio of A's age to B's age after 6 years. Let's consider, I am considering A is to B is equal to 2:3. I can write it as a 2x by 3x. And here B minus A is 6. That is 3x minus 2x is equal to 6. And x equal to 6 years. Here in the question he is asking the ratio of A's age to B's after 6 years. That is, he is asking A's to B's after 6 years. This is the present age ratio, and after 6 years means 2x plus 6 by 3x plus 6. That is 2 into 6 plus 6 by 3 into 6 plus 6. That is 18 by 24. Okay, 18 by 24 means 6 3 is 6 4. That is 3:4 is the answer. And this is the you are solving with elaborately. But within 5 seconds we can solve this question. How means? See here, by the elimination method. And here, see, the ratio between A and B is 2:3. Yes or no? The ratio between A and B is 2:3. Whenever we are going from the present to past, present to future, the ratio will always increase. Okay, the ratio will always increase. Here we will see the 2:3, the value is 0.66, okay, similarly here, and 1:2 means 0.5, and 4:3 means 1.33, that is 4:3, and if we consider 3:4, that is 0.75, okay, 0.75. if we compare this this ratio with the options whatever given in the question, okay, out of these four options we can eliminate some options. If you see this 2:3, after 6 years means always, whenever if we go from the present to the future, always the ratio will be increased, okay, always the ratio will be increased. If you see here, this is 2:3 and this is the 2:3. Whenever we are moving from the present to the future, the ratio will be increased, but it not be same, so that we can easily eliminate this option, okay. If you see this option, whenever if you see this is 0.66 and this is 0.5, as we are moving from the present to the future, the ratio will be increased, but it is not decreased, so this option will also eliminate. And if you see these two options, these two options are greater than 0.66, yes or no? But if you see out of these two options, here the age of A is 2, let us consider 2, the age of B is 3, yes or no? The age of A is 2 and the age of B is 3. If you see here, A is 6 years younger than B. A is 6 years younger than B. That means the age of A is less than B. Yes or no? The age of A is less than B. If you see here, A's age is higher than the B's age. How it is possible? As we are going from this present to the past after 6 years, sorry, present to the future after 6 years, the ratio, the difference between the two ages will be same. Yes or no? As I told in the previous session. Okay, but here the age of A is greater than the age of B, so that this is also wrong. So finally we can select this option. Like this trick can be used whenever we are not able to solve this type of theory questions. Okay, so this is the previous questions of SSC CGL, and I will solve some of other questions of ages like bank exams, SBI PO, SBI clerk, like this. And please follow my videos regularly. And thank you for watching. Please subscribe. Thank you.